Many of us have learned so much about how to successfully work from home over the past several months, myself included. I've taken stock of how I work best and the best way to set up my work from home workspace to be as productive as possible. Today, I'm gonna walk you through that plan and show you my workspace in hopes that maybe it'll inspire you or give you some ideas on how to best set up your workspace. I've mentioned in previous videos that I actually replaced my home office with a gym. Now, for someone who works from home 100% of the time, that really sounds like a stretch. That sounds like it makes absolutely no sense. But I have my reasons. I realized that I never consistently actually worked from my office. I would spread out to the dining room table. I would move around the house depending on the seasons and where the sun was shining. And if I'm being completely honest, there were some days where I would just not go too far from my bed and sit in my bed and start my work day there. I know we all have those days where forcing yourself out of the bed in the morning is the absolute last thing you want to do. So my office area was beginning to become an area of wasted space. So I wasn't using it as an office, and we were kind of using it as a catch-all or the keeping room or just a room where we stash things before we put them away or before we put them in the permanent home. So it really was wasted space. So after assessing what I truly needed in a home workspace, I decided to turn that office into a home gym. Now that space is used almost daily by more than just me. So it's used by, you know, more members of the family. So I certainly feel like that is a more efficient use of the space. And because I live in a home with a smaller square footage and a smaller footprint, I honestly feel like it's very important to make sure we are using all the space within the home in the way that makes the most sense for all of us. So in assessing those things that I needed for my workspace, I ran through a list, or I came up with a list of all the things that I wanted to have in that workspace. So number one was I needed to be close to the action. And by that, I mean I needed to be within earshot of my kids. So they are currently working from home as well. They're doing 100% virtual school. I don't know for how long. It's been for a long time now already. So they are doing school from home 100% of the time. So I really wanted to be within earshot of them, but not so much that they would be disturbing my meetings or anything else that I have going on during the day. I also wanted this workspace to be in a spot that was bright, open, and airy. Because if there's one thing I learned about myself, I like bright light, mostly sunshine. So I want it to be near a window someplace. You know, I like to have my plants around. So I wanted it to be bright, airy, welcoming, and inviting. That's the workspace that I would perform best in. And in that same line of thinking, the third thing I needed on my list for a productive workspace is to be surrounded by visually appealing stuff. I mean, where my office was previously, it was actually in a section of my basement. And while there were windows there and I prettied it up and I made it look nice, it still did not feel pretty. It still felt kind of like a basement. So I'm pretty sure that's exactly why I did not work there most of the time. So with those three things in mind, and the fact that, like I said, my home does have a smaller footprint, it's not like I had a lot of spaces to choose from, but I did decide to use the desk slash vanity area in my bedroom as now my workspace. Now I know there are some major concerns with having your workspace in the same area where you rest. It can sometimes be distracting, or maybe you won't know how to turn the day off or how to end the workday and get into your normal life routine. There will be no separation of rest and work. And also, I mean, if you think about it, not a lot of offices are really aesthetically pleasing. Like, do you want a large monitor in your bedroom? I do not, personally. So I needed to make sure that if I was gonna use this space, that not only would it have to function as an office, but it would also have to be pretty and kind of gel with the environment that I have created in my bedroom. So since I've been working from home for quite a few years, I've already mastered the dichotomy of work and rest. You know, I've already mastered how to separate the two, so that was not a concern for me. So then that leaves the main issue of making the work area in the bedroom cohesive with the design of the actual bedroom. So that requires some ground rules. Obviously, I like lists, so I'm gonna list them out for you. So number one was no large monitors. I do have a job where having multiple monitors or multiple screens would be extremely helpful, but I couldn't do it. I just couldn't do it. I'm not setting up multiple monitors in my bedroom, no way. So I needed to make sure that I could do my job just from a laptop. I also needed to have a place where I could tuck everything away. So there are some things that we need for work on a day-to-day basis, but they don't always have to be out on display. So I just wanted to make sure I had enough storage so that I can put those things away when they weren't in use. I don't need to leave the laptop sitting out on the desk. I don't need to leave my work cell phone or planner out on the desk. You get the idea. I just wanted to make sure I had a place to tuck those things away at the end of the workday, thus further helping separate work time from lifetime or home time. And most importantly, in this whole plan that I set out on, I definitely wanted this to be budget friendly. I didn't want to break the bank setting up a new office. I just felt like it wasn't that necessary. I could kind of get away with using the things that I already had from my previous office and maybe adding in a few more items to increase the organization and the capacity of what I needed to house in this bedroom desk area. That meant I primarily needed to use all the things that I already had on hand to make this come together. And I'll walk you through all those items that I used. Starting with the desk that I'm using in this area. It's actually a console table that I found at a thrift store maybe almost 10 years ago. I'm sure it was less than $10 and it works. The top probably needs to be refinished. Not probably, it definitely needs to be refinished, but that is not a project I'm taking on right now. So I covered it with a desk blotter that I found from Amazon. And anything I mention in this video, I will link down below for you. So I covered it with a desk blotter from Amazon. Looks as good as new. It functions very well for my needs. And the blotter actually helps to work as a mouse pad as well. And here I'm going to give you a closer view of the desk. You can see the blotter on top. It's actually reversible. So it's this cognac color on one side and gray on the other side. And also you can see that the top of the desk definitely needs some refinishing. But the surface works well for me and it gives me a lot of space. This acrylic holder, I put my iPad and other things in through the day. Because this desk is just a console table and not a full desk, it doesn't have a lot of storage. I'm glad that it does have one drawer, so that's very helpful, but it doesn't have a lot of storage. So I had to make sure that I could maximize the efficiency of that one drawer. And I'll get to that in a moment. The next thing I did need for the space was a printer. I don't print things for work. I typically print things for planning or my planning routines or any crafting things that I might do. So I did want to have a printer, and this happened around like Black Friday time when I was looking to make this desk area more efficient for me. So I did see a deal at Walmart for a printer on Black Friday. The one that I actually went there for was out of stock or sold out. So I did get another one, which is bigger than I originally intended to have in this space. It's also black. I wanted a white printer, you know, so it had a few strikes against it, but I figured it was a great deal. I still bought it. And my husband actually still needs a printer in his office in the home. So I figured I would get this one for a good price. And then if I found something that was a bit more aesthetically pleasing for me, I would swap that one out, give the black one to my husband, and then take the nicer one or the prettier one for myself. However, I actually really like this printer and I don't want to give it up. So we'll see if that even happens. And because, like I mentioned, this piece of furniture that I'm using as a desk only has one drawer, I needed extra storage space. So in my previous office, I had two desks. I had a set of drawers from IKEA. The desks were also from IKEA. I have since rehomed those two desks, but I used the set of drawers from IKEA and brought it up here next to my current desk. So that is what the printer is sitting on top of. And in those drawers, I do have a lot of office supplies that I need. And I'm also able to stash my laptop and everything else in there when the workday is over.
This is the Mickey or Mick drawer unit from IKEA. I'll have it linked below. But as you can see, I kind of store or stash any extra things that I have. So I have some index cards, extra pens, an extra stapler, just a bunch of extras that I have or I like to keep within reach. That's the first drawer. And then the second drawer, I have an abundance of post-it notes. All of these colorful post-it notes did come from my office, in my office building, but I decided to bring them home and I do use them for work, but normally the ones I use in my planner are much more neutral. I also have some extra pens and some extra tape dispensers because you never know when you're gonna need extra tape. And then moving on to the third drawer, I don't have a lot in this drawer. It's mostly just supplies. So I do have some rulers and some hole punches and extra discs for my planners. I also have a random seal over there and some extra paper clips, just some extras, like I said. And then the last and final drawer is more like a file drawer, but I don't have a lot of files. So in here, I do keep some sticker books for my planning. I also keep some extra printouts that I have on hand for my planner. And there's a paper cutter or paper trimmer in there as well.
This did cause kind of like a domino effect because I needed a new lamp. Previously, my lamp in this room was on top of the desk. So now that I need the full desk for my workspace, I needed some other kind of lamp or lighting solution. So I decided to get a floor lamp from Target. It was also on sale around the same time, around Black Friday time. So I got a really good deal on it. And I swapped those lamps out so that this one can now sit on the floor in the corner and not take up any surface space. And the last important item that I needed to have in this area was a comfortable desk chair. I actually decided to keep the chair that I currently had here, which was a Home Goods find from years ago. So I'm not even sure, you know, if I could find it again, but I do see chairs in this shape quite often. Mine just so happens to be upholstered, which other ones I see aren't. So I decided to keep this chair instead of swapping it out for an office chair, and I will tell you why. The chair is actually quite comfortable. I have no issues with it. It, like I said, is upholstered, so it does have a little bit of cushioning, which is fine for me and it works. You know, I can sit in it for hours and not be uncomfortable. It has a nice slant to it, so it doesn't cause any back issues or anything like that. So it really does work well as a desk chair for me. Originally, I was thinking I wanted to swap it out for a chair that had maybe like a rolling base, something that was a bit cushionier or a bit plusher so that it might be more comfortable to sit in for hours. But at the same time, because I'm still going with this whole aesthetically pleasing, still has to vibe with my bedroom, I didn't want to bring a chair in that had like wheels on the base. I just felt like it would look like an office chair. It's not necessarily the look I'm going for. So the current chair I have here works. And if I decide to update it in the future, I will be sure to let you guys know. So make sure you subscribe and I'll show any of those updates in upcoming videos on this channel. All right, so that brings me to the most important aspect of this desk or workspace setup. I needed to have organization. And I'll take you through all the drawers and I'll show you how I laid out the drawers and I'll link below the items that I used to set up the organization in these drawers. And remember, this is a budget-friendly endeavor. So I actually used a few things from the Dollar Tree. I used some things from Amazon. Just things that I might have had on hand that I was using for other areas of the house. I swapped it out and brought it in here. So let's take a look at that.
Here is where we're getting into the good stuff. I'm bringing you in closer and I'm going to take out everything I have in this drawer. The drawer is small, but I am able to pack a whole lot of stuff within it. So as I take everything out, and this clip is sped up a bit, I'm taking everything out, and as I put them back in, I'll explain exactly what I have going on in this drawer. So the first thing over on the left, I have some markers that I use regularly, and in this little container, which is actually found in the tool section at the Dollar Tree, so it was a dollar, I just cut off the top, but I have some post-it flags and some sticky notes. Like I said, I have a lot of sticky notes. You are going to see them everywhere, but I do love to use them. A lot of them are from cloth and paper, and you can actually see a lot about the planning supplies I use in my planner playlist that I will have linked down below. These are my sticker books that I use also in my planning or journaling process. I have an extra lip balm and some extra fountain pen ink and a glue stick on hand. And this is another one of those Dollar Tree organizers. In it, I have some plain post-it notes. I have some adhesive tapes and whiteout, also some post-it flags. These smaller containers are ink samples for my fountain pens, and then the larger bottles are also ink for my fountain pens. And then I have this random pack of pen holders from Amazon. I don't know where to put them, so they're there. And again, more post-it notes because I need a lot of them. And here in this little box that I repurposed from someplace, I have some extra pens and pencils that I like to have on hand at all times. So as you can see, everything does fit back in this drawer. And this is a clip that is sped up as well, but I'm trying to kind of jigsaw everything in to figure out, you know, what direction I had everything in, but it does all fit nice and secure. I don't have a lot of room to add extra things, but I find that I don't really need anything else. This is all that I need. So you can see how everything fits back into place and is available for me to use whenever I need it. So after all of that, now this space is perfect for my needs, and I'm sure it will be for years to come. I've already been testing it out for quite a few months, and it's working perfectly. Of course, if I decide to update anything, I'll definitely share it on this channel, so be sure to subscribe if you aren't already. Thank you so much for watching today's video, and I'll see you in the next one.